This is a word I would like to first expound. Amos 9:13 onwards. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that the plowman shall overtake the reaper, and the treader of grapes him that soweth seed. And the mountains shall drop sweet wine, and all the hills shall melt. I'm going to read that again. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that the plowman shall overtake the reaper, and the treader of grapes him that soweth seed. And the mountains shall drop sweet wine, and all the hills shall melt. Prophetically, I declare that this has come to pass. Or rather, we are in the time when these things have happened. Let me explain that to you. Verse 13 says, Prophet Amos says, behold, the days come, or the days are coming. When he speaks these words for the first time, he is looking into the future. Jesus Christ our Lord had yet not come. Amen. They were not under the cross yet. They were rather under the covenant of the old Mosaic covenant, which we call the old covenant. So Amos said, guys, this is coming. The days are coming. And he prophetically was looking at the cross and the day of resurrection. Now that Jesus has come, not only in this world, but Jesus has come into your heart and mine. And because you have the power of resurrection in you, these words are yes and amen in your life. Salvation is personal. Not only salvation from the world, but salvation to be taken up when Jesus comes is also personal. Personal. It's very personal. We are together corporately as a church, because God has many plans for us to be together as a church. But remember, salvation is personal. It is not even family-based. It is personal. One day Jesus comes. Jesus himself taught us, two shall be in a bed, one shall go up. That could be about the family. Two, children. It is personal. Please say with me the word personal if you will. Amen. So this word is to be taken personally. Maybe your neighbor doesn't understand this. Maybe your neighbor likes to believe that you're still going through the desert sands of life. Maybe your neighbor in the church sitting next to you may think that, yeah, one day Jesus is going to come. He is. Then only all the problems will be solved. That is also partly true. But you can believe that whatever Christ has promised to you, for you, is right now happening. It's the way you take it personally. How you take life personally is important. I hope this is clear. Now, those who want to take this word, this is what the Lord has talked to us. It's a beautiful revelatory word that came on a Friday. We had the lowest count on Friday. But those people who came, they were on fire. The word came. This is the word that came. Remember, the plowman shall overtake the reaper, and the treader of grapes shall overtake the one who sows seed. Amen. I'm going to explain that. Hallelujah. Friday evening after the meeting, I did proceed to New York. My wife was with me. We both went to New York. 14 to 15 people gathered. It was a time of power. There was a new believer, a doctor, who came out of the Catholic faith. I'm purposely saying the Catholic faith, not because I have anything to do against the Catholic faith, but he came out of the Catholic faith into the truth of God. And he, his wife, they were all desiring this time. They came. She was filled with the Holy Spirit, with the clear signs of speaking in tongues. God did a great thing. And I was hoping some of you would come. That's okay. Next time. There's always a next time. Great things are in store for us, not only in Pennsylvania, but different states of this country. We are raising up people. I'm also praying for an ordination service to come up. Expect great things from the Lord for this church. Amen. All because I believe which is also the absolute truth, that we are at a time after the cross, after the resurrection of Jesus Christ, we are in the year of the Jubilee. How many of you think you are in the year of Jubilee? Last week we declared it for ourselves. I declared that I am in the year of Jubilee. And in the year of Jubilee, debt free. When you talk about debt, financial debt is the first thing that comes into our mind. Pray, Lord, set me free from debts. How many of you pray that? Set me free from debts. Psychological debts, human debts. I would like all of us in the anybody. No, parents, children, no. I hope you understand. They didn't say anything like that. I'm just using as an example. They never say anything like that. You are debt free in Jesus' name. You are free from the law of Moses. You don't have to go back into that desert sand again. You're free. You're free. We have declared it the year of Jubilee. And this verse which we talk about reflects a nature or a character or a flow of things that happen in the year of Jubilee. So let's look into that first. This is talking about overtaking. Behold, the days come, or the days have come, saith the Lord, that the plowman shall overtake the reaper, and the treader of grapes him that soweth seed. Two categories of people. Number one, the plowman. Who is the plowman? The one who soweth the seed. It's another word for sowing. Sower. The sower shall overtake who? The reaper. When you come into your Christian life, in the first years of your life, I want you to know, though you are with Christ, though you know that Jesus loves you, though you see all the spiritual blessings, you still have a battle in the flesh. How many of you been there? I've been there. And during those days, we erroneously sing songs. When in reality, you have already been released on the cross. Your heart is full of the past life, though God has given you a new heart. For some people, it takes years to transfer from the old heart to the new heart. But for some people, they immediately come to know a new heart has been given to them. I want you to know, I hope you will take it, that you have a new heart. God in the scriptures, the old is gone away. Behold, I do new things. Now, when you go through battles of life in the flesh, it is what you have reaped or you are reaping from what was sown in the past. When we were sowing in the past, it was sowing into the flesh. Even when you are in Christ, to reap from the flesh. But now the word has come. The plowman shall overtake the reaper. Who is the plowman? You, with the Holy Spirit of God, you are beginning to sow seeds of Jesus' character into your heart. Before the days in the flesh, you were sowing into the flesh nature. You had received a lot of nature from your parents, your grandparents, and you're living in the flesh. No hope, no faith. Speaking things that has no hope. For example, you know, have you seen people when they just throw up when things happen? You know, I don't know what to say. That's something that you got from who? Not from Jesus. What would Jesus do in a time of crisis? Come on, let's go for it. Are you getting that? What would Jesus do during a time of coronavirus? Go for it, man. What is your heart saying right now? Shall I tell you what your heart is saying right now? Pastor, it's okay for you. You know, that's the heart. It's not to be condemned. That's the situation of the heart. And Jesus doesn't condemn us, because he knows that we are weak. That is why we have pastors, we have servants of God, who have been given a heart to continuously energize into the energy of Jesus. That is why we say, look at Jesus. How many of you say, look at Jesus? Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. In the 14th century, telling you about Jesus, there was a man who came across a situation when his whole nation was under the plague. Everybody was dying. People were dying. He said, this cannot happen because the name of Jesus is above every other name. He just stood up and started to shout out Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. And he told the people, hey, even in your deathbed, call out the name of Jesus. And immediately things began to happen. That plague was removed. It's written in history. That is expected of us. Now, given by faith that God has given to us, by the grace of God given to us, I've told God, Lord, in case you think that I am fit to go and pray for somebody who has COVID-19, I'm ready. I've told the Lord, I'm not saying I will go there. I told the Lord, I'm available. Somebody receive it. I'm not saying that I am, you know. That itself can destroy the purpose. Because you have to be humble. But why did I say that? Because I know the heart of my God. There are people out there suffering. They have no hope. I said, Lord, it is one thing to stand in the pulpit and preach. If you think that I'm good for it, if you will come with me, and Lord, please lead me to some people. I can pray. Of course, I won't touch them. I don't have to touch them. I can look at them. It won't hit me. But I can pray for them, right? I'm just telling you this, not for you, any of you to do this. Don't do it. Hello? Just expressing what Jesus would do in a situation like this. That's all. Now, where does that heart come from? That heart comes from the book of Ezekiel, which says, behold, I give you a new heart. But even when Jesus has given us a new heart, remember, the plowman, the reaper, that is you, have sown so much into the flesh that your heart is also bringing up thoughts from the flesh. You can't do it. You be careful. Fear not. Fear, you know, be careful. But the time is coming. Because you keep on sowing seeds into your heart, that part is going to overtake what has been sown in the flesh. The days are coming when anger will not rule you anymore. Somebody receive it. The days are coming when some of those is not going to overtake you. Some of those dreams which you can't tell people outside is going to disappear from your life. Some of those things that have a tendency to condemn you, that at the time of prayer, you don't feel like, oh, no, I don't feel like praying. You know why? Because you have associated with something that is condemning you, pulling you down. It shall not be. You shall be people of prayer. Some activity that came from you, some anger, some irritation, some lack of faith, something like that is pulling you away from the presence of God, is going to go away. The plowman is overtaking the reaper. Shall I say, the new man in Christ Jesus is overtaking the old man according to the flesh. That you will understand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Not only that. I love this. The treader of grapes, two people there. The treader, the one who treads grapes. Tread means to bring it under your feet and to squish it and to squash it. And give you squash. Juice. Grape juice. The treader of grapes will overtake the one that soweth seed. How many people are there? Two people are there. Number one, the treader of grapes, the one who squishes and squashes the grape or the full fruit, he will overtake the one who soweth seed. Two people. Who are those two people? Number one, the treader of grapes, who is that? That is the Holy Spirit. And that is you and the new man. You are going to tread the grapes. I'm sorry. You are, the treader of grapes is going to overcome the one that has sowed the seed. Who is the treader of grapes? The Holy Spirit is the treader of grapes. The Holy Spirit is the treader of grapes. He is going to overtake you even as you are sowing new seeds. Did you get it? No, that's the thing. As you sow, you shall not reap. It's not there. It's not here. No. It is not. Listen carefully. Please listen carefully. By faith, listen. Let me read that for you. The treader of grapes is the Holy Spirit, right? What is the fruit that he is treading? Oh, the light is so blaring, son. Grapes, or shall I say the fruit of Jesus? The Holy Spirit is using the fruits of the Lord Jesus Christ, the life of Jesus, making it available for you in fullness, even as you have slowly started to sow a seed. In other words, you are going to get more than what you bargained for because of Jesus. This is a prophetic voice for you, for the church. Let me explain. Finances. Let me explain. This is a simple example. Finances, okay? So when I was in another church, the pastor used to tell me all the time, "You guys, you should tithe. You should tithe. You should tithe. I said, "Yeah, no." And then the Lord began to take a hold of me and said, "You better tithe." I said, "Lord, tithing is old covenant," because I had an understanding of giving money. Tithing is old covenant, Lord. You have to give a portion. The Lord said, "Give something. You're not giving anything. You're not only talking about giving." So I started to give. Even when I had nothing, I started to sow the seed. Amen? When you sow a seed, what happens? It has to become a tree. But the blessings that I have is not depending on that seed. The blessings is dependent on Jesus Christ himself. So even as you seed, make it a big tree, it can remain for your children and your grandchildren and your great-grandchildren, even after you go away. You will be filled with the fruits of Jesus Christ even now. I hope you get this. So who is one here? Who's God victorious here? Jesus Christ. So sowing and reaping, like my sister said, don't wait for your sowing to come to fruition before you begin to enjoy the goodness of God. The goodness of God is yours free. This is a mark of the year of Jubilee. You know what is going to happen? Deep inside our old heart, there are expectations which you have developed, which will come only if you do something or you qualify. But today I want you to know, without qualification, Jesus has given everything to you free. You don't need to qualify. There's only one block there. You know what? This is the block. If I were to write a check for $1,000 and give to any of you, how many of you will take it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, Schwetz, you know. 7, nobody else wants. You know why? No, Pastor, because I'm a man of God. Your understanding of a man of God is, where can this guy get $1,000? He won't rob a bank. Because you think servants of God are called to live in poverty. Yes, sir, I'll give you more than. Jesus will give you more than that. Good girl. See, what you should learn is to receive when God gives you something. Remember Peter. Peter had a vision. What is the vision? There was this particular thing that came down from heaven. He heard the voice, "Rise, Peter, kill, eat." What did Peter say? "I am a Jew." What was in his heart? Pride. Take, eat, kill. Who said that? God himself said that. Holy Spirit said that. So to receive itself is something that we have to learn. If you don't know how to receive, how will your heart receive the death on the cross? Jesus died on the cross for you. Free. You didn't ask him, did you? I didn't ask him to die for me. He said, "I love you. That is why I'm dying for you. I'm the one who starts this love affair." Aren't you excited to know that? And the Bible says, it is not that you loved me, I loved you. What an amazing God. So remember, the year of Jubilee is not about you doing something. It is not about you doing a lot of things. One day I shall see my husband baptized. Oh my God. That's not the right thing. That is a law. Today, if you can take it, you will take it. Today. 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 Today is the day. Today. 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 Come on. I'm speaking prophetically. Today. I know somebody who's visiting us for the first time. Sister, we'll meet with us. Bear with us. I'm a bit crazy around here. But I love you in Jesus' name. Get ready to meet after this. This is the way we talk. Today, when I say the word today in Jesus' name, in the Holy Spirit, your hearts are being transferred from the old heart of unexpected expectation, 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 expectation. I tell you today in the name of Jesus, it is finished. On the cross, telaio. How do you say that? Oh, telaio. I shall tell like that, telaio. It is finished. Because on the cross of Calvary, Jesus took everything that will come through on your flesh. He took it on himself. And he overcame. He overcame not only himself, he overcame our flesh, our sins, our flesh pattern, those lusts of the flesh, those things that are likely to condemn you. He took it on him in the cross of Calvary. He said, it is finished. That's a new covenant. Now we need one more thing there. You need to be empowered to receive this truth. You need to have the Holy Spirit inside you. You need to have the power of the Holy Spirit. If you ask me, there are essentially two things that we need. Number one, believe that it is finished on the cross of Calvary. Number two, receive the power of the Holy Spirit. If you have these two things, it is done. You are more than conquerors. So read that with me again. How many of you are ready to flow in that anointing today? The new covenant anointing where everything is finished on the cross of Calvary. You are empowered with the Holy Spirit that we are now going to move not as a double standard church. You know what this? Some people say we are under the law, though they don't say that, they behave that they are under the law. You are not under the law. You are under grace. We are one church, one body that says that Christ has finished it all. Now we are going to enjoy the fruits of what Jesus did on the cross. Amen. Yesu Christu crucial purti akya deiva pravarti aswadikana ninne enne vilichekku. Did you get that? Same thing. God has called us to enjoy the fruits that is in Christ Jesus. Is this in the scriptures? Philippians 1:10. Let's go there quickly. Philippians 1:10. Philippians 1:10. See what Paul says? There you may approve things that are excellent. There you may be sincere and without offenses till the day of Christ. Verse 11, being filled with the fruits of righteousness, which are by Jesus Christ, unto the glory and praise of God. Did you get that? Would you read that with me? May you be filled with the fruits of righteousness, which are by Jesus Christ, unto the glory and praise of God. I'm taking it. Rina, are you taking it? Children, are you taking it? Because it is very personal. I'm asking you. Pastor George, Sister Jesse, Pastor Thomas George, Sister Mercy, Brother Vinu, Sheena, I'm just calling out names. Brother Babakutti, Brother Cherian, are you taking it by faith? It is something personal. Listen, Mama, right there. Are you receiving it? Are you taking it? Leanna, are you taking this? Rani, are you taking this? Betsy, are you taking this? It is personal. Take it. I can't force you. That's not my job. I can tell you that He, Christ, His fullness is on you. Praise God. In Malayalam, we have a saying, you know, it happened to Vagayada. This is my father's property. How many of you know that this is your father's property? The new covenant is your father's property. Moses under the old covenant, that is my master's property. This is our father's property. Receive it in Jesus' name.